Hey YouTube, Grecian Thunder here with another episode of Alphabet City. This is the mall, covering my M's today. Probably gonna go fairly quick, because as you can see, I mean, you know, it's not as big as others, but those are my M's. Yeah, we'll get started here. Alright, first up, we've got a little Taj Mahal. This is, oh, the Natural Blues, sorry, Columbia. Alright, up next is one of my favorite bands. I've got most of their records. Me and Savonius have talked about him before, but this is The Makeup with I Want Some, double album. On K Records. Great band. Founders of the gospel Yeah Yeah sound. Definitely look into it. This is The Makeup After Dark. This is on Discord. That's Ian right there. And one of my first girl band crushes, Michelle May. Hot. This was the first record I picked up from them. This is Makeup Destination Love, live at Cold Rice. And a couple of their records are that live feel to them. Whether or not they're actually live, I don't know. This is The Makeup. I think this is one of the last records they released, Save Yourself. And they do a cover of Hey Joe on here that's really awesome. It's on K Records. And finally, this is The Makeup. This is the second record I bought from, In Mass Mind. They actually recently reissued these. And this is also on Discord. And I'm thinking about picking them up because these copies are kind of whooped. I've played them so much. You know, replacing them. Plus, they come with download cards now. That's one thing about records I love these days is the download cards. Kind of makes it worth it, you know? Because I'm really against pirating music. It's always been a thing for me. Kawabata Makoto. Picked it up at the Asa Mothers show. Michisita Shinsuke. The Circle. Circle, square, triangle. Kawabata Makoto. This is White Summer of Love Dreamer. Really cool, kind of in the vein of Sleep and bands like that. This is a band called Mamatus or Mamatus. This is The Coast Explodes. You can read the description there, just to kind of give you an idea. I like this album a lot. They actually have another record I was going to pick up. Really like this record. I mean, I've been getting into it. Takes a few listens, but I just put it on when I'm, like, you know, reading or surfing the interweb or what have you. But Master Musicians of Bukkake. It sounds to me, I mean, like, like I said, I've only listened to it, like, maybe two or three times, but, like, it's, like, really chanty, and, there's a lot of crescendo, and, like, native, you know, folk instruments, I guess, that I, you know, what I've heard so far, and it's just, it's really good music. I highly recommend this. Curtis. This album is sweet! Up next, this is a pretty rare one. It's only the only Melvins I have, but they did, like, kind of, I mean, they're, if anybody knows about the Melvins, they're really big into Kiss, and they did their own, like, solo records. This is the King Buzzo solo record. I got it at Wazoo Records in Ann Arbor, Michigan. And Side 2 has a song called Skeeter. It's pretty well known. It's got Dave Grohl basically telling a story over really awesome music. I mean, pretty much. Dale Nixon is the drummer on this one. So, Dale Nixon is a big ass drummer. Next, this goes out to Sid. This is my copy of Men at Work. Hers is in black and white, mine's in yellow. This is usual. Only Men at Work I have. I don't know if I really need to get any more, you know. this is a band called Metal. They're from Portland. Really, I guess post-rock, atmospheric. Yeah, look them up. It's called Fearful Metal. I think it's from like 2 or 3 years ago. Only Metallica I own, but you know, Justice for All, it's a pretty good album. I mean, my favorite's Master of Puppets, but I'll probably end up picking it up one day. I'm not too sure if I want to get those remastered 45 speed ones or not. I keep hearing that they don't sound as good, but you know, if you guys know for sure, you've listened to them, let me know. What else we got next? Got an album from the Mighty Caesars. And this one is called John Lennon's Corpse Revisited. Good garage rock. 89. Buddy Miles action, them changes. I need to get more Buddy Miles. Really good, like jazz, funk, soul. I'm digging that drum set, man. That is tits. Yeah, this guy, he's where it's at. Really cool band on the live natural sound recordings, Mondo Drag. Kind of a, you know, I mean, you can kind of tell that's them in the front here. They kind of go for that space rock, early 70s thing a little bit. But yeah, I mean, I would definitely check this out. Look for it. Give it a listen, see what you think. There was a Hawkwind comparison, and I think that's why I picked up on it. I don't really get it necessarily. I think they're doing their own thing, but fun. Up next, Mountain, Twin Peaks, double live album. One of the records is Nantucket Sleigh Ride, which is rad. I mean, what can you say about Mountain, man? Oh, so great. And this is definitely, I don't know if this is a reissue or not, but it's in mint edition. When I picked it up, and I think I only got it for like $8 or $9. And I've seen it out there a lot more whooped. And I think these last records are all my Mummy's records. It's the Mummy's. Never been caught. Kings of Budget Rock. This one's on Telstar. Really got into this band, which I still am. This is the Mummies with Party at Steve's House. And this one is on Hit Up Records. And Steve, I guess, is Steve Mark. this might be a bootleg. Obviously, it's got a blank back cover, but Tales from the Crypt. And these last two, and I have actually, there's like an empty Party at Steve's House sleeve for some reason. And then this is a record that I've lost somewhere along the way, but still have the cover. The Mummies play their own records. Okay, and then these last two are on Estrus from 96. And actually, the Mummies came through town last year, last summer, I think, August. And I got off work, and I should have bought tickets, and I rode my ass as fast as I possibly could down to the venue, sold out like 5 minutes before I got there. And I'm not the kind of guy who's going to stick around and listen outside just because I really like a band. I'm too old for that. You know? But yeah, this is Running on Empty, Volume 1. It's got a, you know, story there. This guy's really, really cool. And one of their mottos. Yeah, on Never Been Caught. They put this throughout a lot of their records, and this is pretty much, I think, what got me into the whole vinyl kick. Is like, I started picking up these guys' records, and I'm like, you know what, they were right. And what do you know, CDs are on their way out. The records are making a comeback. And then finally, this is the Mummies, Running on Empty, Volume 2. Love those guys, love those records. And those are the M's, my friends. Stay tuned. Probably going to consolidate more because, you know, it's like, it fluctuates, so it gets a little loony. Yeah, see you next time, and I hope you guys are having a great weekend. I got to go to work. But I love my job, so. Oh, and side note, I mean, personal info. I work at IKEA, so those Expedit shelves, I think that's the only reason I started working there, is I was like, oh, those are great for my records. So I applied. Next thing you know, I've been there almost 3 years now, so. I hope you guys, like I said, have a great weekend. Much love to y'all, and loving the new videos, and I just threw up a thread that I recorded a couple nights back. So stay tuned for that, and stay tuned for this, and I'll see you soon. Leave comments and tell your friends.